Yo, what's up guys? My name is Blackybear. Today we have an account takeover of Gh8r. And he wanted me to check his account and figure out if we have a way to beat Vapordreamland stage 90 hard and stage 90 100 if we were able to defeat it. So yesterday, late in the night, I went into his account and I did achieve defeating everything on the heart, and I filmed it. At the end of this video, there will be a clip with all the stages that I've done, which sped up quite a bit because it took quite some time. And then after that, we went into Lair to build up his Lair team again and build up a good, successful Hydra team. Keep in mind, Gh8r to rune up your PvP type monsters and all that. I explain everything in the video that is coming next to this clip. So please guys, enjoy account takeover Gh8r. Okay, I killed the evil Chimera without killing the guards now, but it was a quite difficult feat to accomplish. Like, as you can see, they're not down and now they will be down. The reason for that, you're lacking the DPS and this guy cannot tank it out completely yet. But actually, the use of Cleopatra made it work. I think without Cleopatra, you can easily go like this, because now there's a lot less damage going on. Also, I think if you jungle hard is a bit more tanky by upgrading that rune, but I don't have the Kalyanite right now. That will help one as well, and then you can just straight go into the lair. Also, an option is to throw out this guy, and maybe now when the guards are down, when we take a little bit less damage, it's possible to use Athena as well. So I need to put a rune on slot 2, so let's do that real quick. But if she doesn't have any speed, we might be able to get the jump right at the beginning. That's it just has to be a rune. Preferable conflict, so we get the complete set, but no speed on the rune, because speed basically ruins it. So if I go with defense, it's fine, no speed on there. So with the guards down, let's see if we can do a run where we can kind of kill them early on. Oh, I messed. Don't need them, I need you. I need Tina. We go into lead. Let's see. So what will happen is she moves first, buffs up, then the druid, well actually first the succubus will go, then the druid will go, and then she will go. Extending the boss. It might be possible to run her at speed now instead, so she buffs, extends the buff a bit earlier on of the druid as well for immunity. Then you take less damage on those units. So that's something we can try, but let's just try this out real quick and see where we're at. Maybe we can do a good team when the guards are down. With the guards up, you definitely need the golem to get it done. Okay, let's see. We buff, we debuff him, we buff that, we extend everything, we start hitting him. And then Athena goes, and he should jump. But now, the question is, can we do enough damage when he's countered? And I think the question is, the answer is no, because the boss, we don't have sanctifications on. Actually, that went well. Wow, that was a lot of procs, I think. Okay, one unit died, which is the front unit, which was Succubus. Okay, we actually got him to jump again. That's actually not bad. I do feel like we can improve on this, but for now, this seems legit. As you can see there, I kind of failed with the... So two units die, but the main reason for that is because if you look at it, The druid and all that, they're on the front line and they kind of move in such a way that they, and the succubus, that they are a bit too fast. I could slow them down, let them, and or speed up junglar, but I needed HP on her because she was dying all the time. And I don't have Kali Knight to improve, so I think this is a great team if you kill the guards. It's probably faster than if you do it without. You could check if we put in Arcanist, for example, but that's not going to add more damage mainly because the swordsmen have that chance of hitting more times. So we'll leave it at that for now. Now we're going to focus on a Hydra team. Okay, I built a few teams in Hydra and I think this one is the best one to run with. So we went with Cleopatra just for the Eye of Horus and obviously making sure she's gonna survive. So she's on speed, HP, HP. She kind of needs to be a little bit more tanky, but we don't have the Kali Knight right now. Then we have the succubus, basically your fastest unit on max hit, high speed. We have the Arcanist on high crit damage. He has pretty good runes. And I used the Enchantress with the Transplant. Transplant is basically a loose skill. He will not use this at all. And she's on crit damage on Berserk. She could definitely get some upgrades on the runes and Yuki. And I think it's better to run with the passive of the Vampire than it is with this passive, because this is kind of RNG. Well, this is pretty safe. And I think this is a good option. I also have an idea to get the first skill of the Ogre of the Orc Warrior onto Yuki, because that's actually a better skill maybe for this whole thing. Only at the boss states that's not true, so I don't think it will work. But right now I think Yuki with that passive will make this first two waves very safe. And that's that's really what I want to make sure, that it's a safe run, right? But we'll have to wait and see how it performs. But I think this is the way to go. Also, a Holy Swordsman could be used. Let's just target the middle boss for now to make it a fast run. Obviously, you don't have to target the middle boss. It's just going to speed up the process, basically. And we should be ready. Yeah, there we go. Okay, now the boss states, the most important one. We certainly do not have the armor rig up, but we get it here. And she does. That was her first kill. Like, Arcanus really does the damage right now. And Yuki is just there to boost her attack, so we keep off getting turns. So Stall Steel doesn't do bad damage. It could definitely be better, but it's not terrible. Okay, they die. Arcane Shock again. There we go. This is the only issue I have now, that Cleopatra is keep healing Yuki when she should really heal herself. That's a bit of an annoying. That's really a problem basically in this situation. We can also try to use a Holy Swordsman because they have a high damage output, but their first skill is single hit, so the defense break will fall off. Okay, I think I figured out a team that would work, and it is the following team. Where is she? So this would be the team. I ruined Cleopatra a little bit where she is more tanky, less speed, but I ruined this slot onto her so she can tank the damage better. And she is just the same on swift HP hit, so decent health, max hit, high speed. Arcanus is on great runes actually. He has good crit, good attack, could be improved a little bit. He's not max crit, but it doesn't really matter. Ashandra is not terribly runed. She does lack some damage, but I use Transplant because this skill will not be used at all, which is great, because then she only does a 1 and 2 skills, which are great skills that they will use. And she's actually not bad. Berserk, crit damage, and I got some nice rolls on this Wild Rune with crit, so that's cool. And Yuki, I changed Yuki a bit around where she's on speed, crit rate and attack. So he will do a little bit more damage, and I do think Endless AP, the Demonic Swordsman passive, will make this this run a lot more safer, because you don't have to worry about the first two waves at all, because you're just going to take turns every time, and you get through that really safe and easy. And I think I can use the passive of the Ogre as well, because see what happens then, but then we don't get the attack gauge boost, and I think the attack gauge boost is quite useful. So there we go. First wave is relatively safe, and every skill is getting used. And because we get another turn, we get them also on the next boss as well. So I'm going to target the middle boss to make it quick, but here we get the armor break again, so that's nice. And if we get lucky enough, we should not be sitting here too long, because it's actually nice if the succubus uses both skills, because then she has the armor break up right at the boss. That won't always happen, but if it happens, it helps to get the speed time better. And since everyone is a multi-hit, they actually don't take that much damage, so we could even think about supplementing Cleo out if you want to make it 100% survivable, but then you need to make sure that Cleo is substituted by someone that could sustain the team. But it's definitely an option. It's not a bad option, to be honest. So it could be something we could look into, because this seems to work without having, like, he has to attack, obviously. But as we can see, because he has armor broken, every debuff is on him, he still really doesn't do that much damage. Now I cannot heal my units up, so you will see people dying most likely at some point. Unless he doesn't go again. But there is a thing to say that we could replace Cleo for an AoE healer or something that has a multi-hit on skill 1. I'm not sure if we have one build up right now, but that's an option. But otherwise, Cleo is just a fail safe, and it's an armor breaker as well, so it helps. And there we go. He should be down now. It's a slower run, but I think it's 100% safe, and that really matters. And we could check if Cleo can go out and go with max crit. But then we need to figure some unit out that actually gets a multi-hit in and doesn't do a single hit. And I don't think we have a great option for that. We could try to YOLO it, as in doing DPSers only. But I don't know, man. It's like, she is definitely an option, because she has a multi hit on skill 1, and these are heals, and is also a heal, so we could rune up her and see how that goes. Maybe that's even better. Let's see if that works better or not. Okay, we're back at it, and what we're gonna try now is run that unit as a healer. She is runed up with as much conflict as I could put her on, just speed defense, because I didn't have an HP one, and the only maxed out HP rune. So I think she's relatively tanky, and I think this might work better. We have to wait and see if it actually works better, but as you just saw in the video, the first the first run was so safe, you don't need Cleo, and it would be sad to use a Cleo if it's not necessary, because then we can rerune her to a slot 2 speed instead. Because I think the damage mitigation on her is good, but if it's that safe, it really doesn't matter. So first wave, easy, quick and done. Second wave, we don't have the armor break directly. That sucks, but it's okay. It will come. Succubus has us ready soon enough. So note that I do not target anything right now. I just leave it go as it is. Oh god. Okay. They did move there, so it's a little bit risky. I did survive, so it's not a bad thing. But it's something to keep in mind, because if she dies, this obviously is not going to go as well as it was before. Okay, there we go. She should heal up to max health if she heals. Yeah. And now we need an armor break. I hope for an attack break. Ah, okay. Here we can see that it doesn't work the way I wanted to, because the first time it was an attack break on the boss, which made it survive. So we really do need the Cleo. So it was a good try, but I think this is the safest run we're gonna get. And I'm not gonna target anything, not the middle boss or anything, to see how good it does, because actually if the middle boss hits, you might lose a unit. That could be annoying, but it's not the end. There's also another thing I could try. There's a passive on the Enchantress that basically shares damage with other units. That could be something where you can substitute Cleo out, but I think, to be honest, it's not gonna make the run better. So for now, I think Cleo is just a necessary unit to have in. If you target the middle boss here, it will be a faster run, 100%. If not, you are a bit left over to luck. But one of the good things is that most of the units have an AoE type of skill, so it's not going to be completely random. There we go, he's dead. Probably do not have the attack buff. Oh, we actually do, that's perfect. It won't be like that, like always, but if it is like that, it won't just increase the speed run. Okay, let's see if we can get some armor breaks on him before he moves. So right now, Yuki went that much times that we actually get a move on our whole team, which is amazing, because it's just a big, big difference, and keeps your team going a lot easier. Okay, but as right now we did die, so I kind of hope we have enough defense now with Cleo that she will always survive. The good thing is Yuki died, because he's on an attack rune right now. He will die more easily. There we go, that was quite well. And we get another turn of Cleo. We're gonna take a big hit there, but we survived relatively well. I think this is 100% safe, man. And that's really what it is, what you need. I mean, you will not get a 10 second run, but that's okay. 2 minutes, 100% safe. This is really what will get you all the good stuff and no fails. So I want to do a quick overview of your teams. So for Lair, if you kill the guards, it's relatively easy. But if you do not, then you can run something like this. If you don't want to kill the guards, what worked for me this time would be putting in one of those and putting in a Cleo. That actually worked out great, because then the Cleo kind of survives and lets everyone go. Or instead of the Cleo, you can also run Arcanus, but Arcanus does have a bit of a trouble surviving as well. So those are the options you have right there. But I think if you do not have the need of that, you can just go with your Holy Swordsman's and with Athena to get like a full rotation and then get him to jump. If you get your Holy Swordsman sanctified, that would be a great improvement on this team. So as soon as you pull more Holy Swordsmen, please do so, because this team is actually really, really strong then. Because as soon as he jumps and he goes below 50%, it's 100%, you know, you will never get an awkward situation where your Holy Swordsman didn't proc at all and you don't get another turn. So let's just run that one more time, see how it goes. This is with the guards down, so keep in mind the damage they receive is far less than with the guards up. But this is probably the best way to do it. So he will jump now. We got lucky with one swordsman. And if you would run Scorn on one or two Holy Swordsmen after this 50%, they will deal 30% more damage. That is an immense amount. My succubus sadly died, which is painful. But we got him to jump right away, which is great. So that makes for a quick team, quick runtime there. And I think this team can be improved if you focus on some of the good wounds that are on the units to max them out, especially slot 2, 4, and 6. And also focus on getting, if you get another Holy Swordsman, do not build another one, but sanctify. That's such a big difference. So this is a good lair team. For Hydra, you just seen it. And do note, I did not rune up everything because... frankly, I don't know what to put on any units anymore. For example, Flame Spirit is not ruined. Your PvP units, you have to rune up. Spider Queen, I de-ruined her to get some other runes. And there are some units that you have to build that are in your storage for PvP. But those two teams, if you leave those as it is, you have great farming teams there. But I did pull out all the runes to get, for example, get a good Abyss Lord for Spire because he's great. Build up Yuki for Spire, so he's amazing. This is basically swapping out this rune to an HP rune, and you're good to go for Spire because he doesn't need to do the damage. The only unit that I didn't rerune was Medusa. So keep in mind that some units are not runed up right now, and you have to do that. The reason I'm not ruining them up is because I don't really have runes left over that I think are gonna work amazingly, and I'm not gonna waste a lot of time trying to build a unit that I'm not having the runes for. And I think your main focus should be farming lair, getting more Kalyanite, getting more runes, upgrading the right runes, getting more speed, and then rune up your arena team, obviously. Yeah, sure, you can throw up the runes now, but I would try to make your teams within the runes, the units that are runed up. Obviously, you can rune up a few more. I mean, that's not like you don't have runes left. So we're going to end the party with a summon session. A small one, because I think he doesn't have that many. We have a few. So let's go. I'm not sure you have all these units, so I'll leave that for what it is. I think you have all them. Let's go, evil. Let's get a Bone King right here, right now. Lightning. Ogre. That was close, though. You know it. Okay. Lightning Dark. Let's go. I will not get the lightning now, I guess. Nah. Was to be foreseen. Okay. Let's go. Light and Dark, Legendary, let's go, let's go. What is it? Ah, Thorn Spirit. Too bad. Too bad. I'm not sure if we have anything in here. No, we don't. That's okay. No insane unit summon, but hey, we got it. We got a good team. I think Golem is something you can actually use as well in Apex and in normal arena, not so much, but definitely use him as well. And for the main use of the units I have on here are for, so we can derune her for you, so you can rune up the rest of the units, but I'll just leave the units ruined up that I used for the teams. So spire units, I went with a hit rune on him because of the spire reason. So for now you can obviously, like this skill has a silence, I believe. Yeah, silence. So that's why I went with the hit rune on him. You can obviously change this out for something else, like attack or HP. But that was just for that. And I needed this defense rune on her to make her more tanky, to make your Hydra team more reliable. The Druid, the Swordsman, the Golem, and the Succubus, the Arcanist, the Athena, the Elven Queen are all, and the Jungle are all ruined up for Lair. This unit can definitely be improved with more HP, so upgrade the runes a bit, especially this one. Yuki is built for Hydra slash Spire. This one is just the rune you can swap out to, for example, HP for Spire, and it could be attack as well. It doesn't really matter because the team kind of moves, doesn't move, you only move. This guy is built for Spire. Also, this guy, Dragoon, is built for Spire. He is the one to tank all those boss units. I do not have your current farmer ruined up, so we'll just lock and set this as main unit for the time being. And he is also ruined up for Spire. Really need him because of the passive. And Medusa didn't change anything, but he's ruined up for Spire as well. So that's how the runes are divided right now. I think you should keep it like that for the time being and rune up the rest of your units, like rune up your farmer and rune up your arena team yourself. And you should be good to go. I hope this helps you and you can get everything going, like every farming and getting some more Kalyanite, because that's really the issue. I started the takeover with no Kalyanite, so I can't really rune up everything right now, but I took the best stuff and put it on the teams that where we need it for. And I just saw someone summoning a new unit. Who is it? Lord Ghetto. I don't know him, but congrats to him. Okay, thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.